Hello students, so today we will start a new chapter, that is air pollution and control, which is very important. Okay, so nowadays by our activity day by day the air is getting polluted. Actually all the environmental elements getting polluted. So today we will discuss how air is getting polluted, what is the importance of this chapter and how we can control. Okay, so all these topics are including in this chapter, that is air pollution and control. The module is 2 and lecture number is 7. Okay, so this is the environmental science. The name of the subject is our environmental science. The subject code is MC301 or 401, and these are the some of the course objectives that we have. You able to understand that the natural environment and its relationship with the human activities. You can apply the fundamental knowledge of science and engineering to assess the environmental and health risk. You can understand the environmental laws and regulation to develop the guideline and procedures for the health and safety issues. And also you will, after this course, you will able to sort out some of the types of problems which is related to air, water, noise, land, etc. Okay, so these are the some of the course objective. Now what are the course outcome? Again, you can understand these are the some of the course outcome of our course, that is you can understand the natural environment and its relationship, the fundamental knowledge you can apply for solving the problems, you can develop some of the guidelines and procedures to sort out the problems, and also you acquire some of the skills which is related, which is beneficial to sort out the problems of some of the critical issues of the environment. So these are the some of the course outcome that we have for our course. This is the lecture plan for the air pollution. Okay, and these are the some of the objectives of our class. Today we will discuss about the components of environment. What are the components of environment that we have we will discuss. Also we will see what are the type, what do you mean by air pollutants, what are the types of air pollutants we have. Also we will see the classification of air pollutants, yes, and all the biochemical effects of that air pollutants. If we have that air pollutants in our air and which we are inhaling continuously, constantly, what are the biochemical effects we can have? Or the biochemical effects for the any type of living system can have, that we will discuss also in this today's class. Okay, now components of environment. Okay, so components, what are the components of environment that we have? That is generally the environment is the whatever we have, the physical, chemical, biological factors, all type of living, non-living system, all are components, all are all together called by the environment. Okay, now components of the environment are generally divided into some of the part like atmosphere. We have atmosphere, we have hydrosphere, lithosphere and biosphere. Atmosphere, the sphere of air. Hydrosphere, generally what are the whatever we have, the water resources in our planet, that is called by the hydrosphere. Lithosphere, whatever the land resources we have, that is called by the lithosphere. And biosphere, obviously the all the living systems are including this system, that is called by the biosphere. Yeah, so this is the types of the environment or classification of the environment that we can do. One is abiotic components and one is biotic component. Biotic components means all type of whatever the organisms, the living organisms we have, that is called by the biotic components. Now abiotic components again of three types: lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere. As I told you, lithosphere, igneous rock, sediment rock, metamorphic rock. So these are the three types of lithosphere we have. Hydrosphere, surface water and groundwater we have. Again, the surface water is of two types. One is saline water and one is fresh water. And next, atmosphere, we all know that atmosphere we can divide into troposphere, then stratosphere, then mesosphere, then thermosphere. And then thermosphere are of two types. One is ionosphere and one is exosphere. Here, biotic components, that is biosphere, are of two types. One is plant kingdom, one is animal kingdom. Okay, so whatever produces, all the producers are including this plant kingdom. Okay, and the whatever animals we have in our environment, that is called by animal kingdom. So this is all of the components of our environment that we have. Okay, so these are the some of the layers, some of the components of the atmosphere that we have. First of all, we have the troposphere. Next, we have the stratosphere. Then we have mesosphere, then thermosphere, and then exosphere. And in between this, we have also the ionosphere. Troposphere generally up to 10 to 12 kilometer the extended. Okay, troposphere generally the over the earth surface, surroundings the earth surface, we have the troposphere, right? After that troposphere, we have the stratosphere. Stratosphere mainly made of the ozone layer. So what is the importance of the stratosphere? Generally, what will happen, these ozones, from the solar energy, we are getting so many radiations, okay, the UV radiations, infrared radiations, which are very harmful for our, excuse me, which are very harmful for us, okay, for our skin, for us, any type of living system. Now, what will happen by this stratosphere, by the oxygen ozone layer, what will happen, it will absorb, the UV radiation will be absorbed by the stratosphere, and for which we are not exposed to the UV radiation, and which is very harmful for us. Okay, so this is the importance of stratosphere. Now next we have the mesosphere. Achha, stratosphere is up to 50 kilometer is extended. Above that we have the mesosphere, which is 90 kilometer. Above that we have the thermosphere, which is around 800 to 900 kilometer extended. And at the uppermost layer, that is the exosphere. Here we have also the ionosphere, where all types of ions, free radicals are there. So these are the some of the components of atmosphere that we have. Okay, now air pollutants. We will discuss about the air pollutants. Now what will happen day by day, as I told you, day by day the air is getting polluted. You can see here, these are the from these industries, from automobile engines, from any type of various factories. Now we are getting so many unwanted emissions of the smoke, which containing carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, then sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide. All these are increasing. All these are very harmful for any type of living system and increasing the level of कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड, नाइट्रोजन डाइऑक्साइड इन आवर एनवायरमेंट एंड विच इज वेरी हार्मफुल फॉर अस ऑल्सो. ओके, सो दैट इज वाई वी शुड बी वेरी कंसर्न अवेयर ऑफ दिस एयर पॉल्यूशन. बिफोर दैट, इफ वी नो वॉट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ एयर पॉल्यूटेंस वी हैव एंड हाउ वी कैन how they are affecting us, that time only we can solve the problem. We can remove that, we can reduce the emission of that air pollutants, and thus air pollution, we can reduce, we can decrease the air pollution, okay, for our sustainability, right? So air supplies us with oxygen, which is very essential of our body. Air is 99.9% of nitrogen, oxygen, water vapor, and so many inert gases are there. Okay, by human activities, air is getting polluted. Yes, as I told you, by our activity, because from automobile, day by day, the production of industries, the productions of factories are increasing, and they are not at all maintaining the policy what they should maintain preserving our environment. Okay, so that is why the environment is getting degraded day by day. There are several main types of pollutions well known, which is like smog. These are the very well known common terms that we know, like acid rain, smog, greenhouse effect, global warming. Global warming, this term is also very known to everyone. Because due to the global warming, day by day the temperature is increasing. Okay, by 10 degrees centigrade. So that's why it's very harmful. Ozone holes in the ozone layer. As I told you, ozone in the stratosphere, all the ozone layer is absorbing the radiation, UV radiations, which is harmful for our body. So that ozone layer, in that ozone layer, for the pollution, some of the holes are created, which is also very harmful. Each of these problems has serious implications for our health and well-being, as for the whole environment. Okay, so that is why this the chapter is included to your course, as because you have to be very aware, and thus you can also make our society aware and make your surroundings aware about this pollution. Okay, these are the classification of air pollutants. Air pollutants are generally three types. One is based on origin, based on the states of the matter, and based on the presence in environment. So these are the three types of air pollutants that we have. So based on origin, we have primary pollutant and secondary pollutant, right? We will discuss, don't worry, we will discuss in detail. Now, based on the states of matter, generally there are two types of air pollutants that we have: gaseous air pollutants and particulate matters. Particulate air pollutants or particulate matter also you can say. Based on presence in environment, indoor air pollutants and outdoor air pollutants. This is also another type of air pollutants that we have. Okay, so these are the types of air pollutants. Okay, now what are the source? So very common, you know, like from the automobile, from industry, from volcanic eruption. So all these are the main responsible person which is emitting unwanted smokes, which is emitting the pollutants to the air. there are many sources of gases and particulate matter pollutants we have, like burning of fossil fuels, right? Burning of fossil fuels like coal, petroleum, diesel. So what will happen? They are emitting always carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, or sulfur nitrogen oxides, hydrocarbons, particulate matter. Like fertilizer plants, where the factories, where the fertilizers, they are making the fertilizers. From there also, the air pollutants are emitting. From different chemical plants, constantly there are so many products are producing, and harmful gases are also evaporating. So these are also the sources. Steel plants, from the steel plants generally carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, iron, particulate matter, these are the things that is emitting. And at last the automobile engines, from the automobile industries, the carbon dioxide, again carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, hydrocarbons, particulate matter, all these are emitting. So these are the mainly sources of the air pollutants. Okay, now air pollutants, based on the origins, generally air pollutants are of two type. One is primary pollutant and second one is secondary pollutant, right? So primary pollutant mainly what are these? Like in our environment we have carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, but in limited amount, which is important for us. Okay, so these are the, while these are the gases are in the limited amount, that is important for us, but they regularly, day by day, gradually their amount is increasing in the air, and which is creating the pollution. Like if we have higher amount of sulfur dioxide, so with the help of the water droplets, like rainy season, okay, so what will happen with the help of that water droplet, that sulfur dioxide convert into the sulfuric acid, and which is called acid rain. Understand? So these are the some of the types of primary pollutants. These pollutants, generally these are the elements that we have in our environment, but while they are in the limited amount, they are not at all the pollutants. While they are beyond the limited amount, that time they are creating the pollution, and that is called by the primary pollutant. Okay, burning of fossil fuels, all you know, these are the gaseous are emitting, and thus they are increasing the amount of the amount of these gases into the environment, which is harmful. Okay, secondary pollutant, they are not present into the environment. Actually, for our activity, what will happen, we are producing these secondary pollutants, and which is again polluting the environment, like ozone. Only ozones are important for the stratosphere. Okay, but in the troposphere, due to our work, what will happen, the ozone is creating, and which is also which is the harmful for us in the troposphere. Ozone, why ozone in the stratosphere, it is important and it is beneficial for us, but while it will be in the troposphere, then it will become a pollutant. This is a secondary pollutant. Like PAN, like sulfuric acid, these are all the creating by us, by our activity. So these are the secondary pollutant. Okay, next we have one type of pollutant, that is a criteria pollutant. Criteria pollutant generally are recognized or identified like this way. The six pollutant which is actually polluting our environment, that is called by the criteria pollutant. Okay, there are six pollutants which have main contribution in creating the air pollution, that is called by the criteria pollutant. What are those? That is carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, lead, ground level ozone and particulate matter. These are the six main air pollutant that is contributing the pollution, contributing towards the pollution. Okay. So generally from this industry, from agriculture, from the wildfires, from the automobile engines, from the domestic from buildings, from homes, whatever their emission they're emitting, they are this six type of gases they are emitting and which is called by criteria pollutant. Okay, now we will see what are the source and effect of that of this criteria pollutant. So first of all, carbon monoxide. The source of this carbon monoxide is generally it is colorless, odorless, poisonous gas. It present nature due to incomplete burning of fossil fuels. Generally, while we are burning incomplete, the fossil fuels are burned incompletely. That time, the carbon monoxide generated rather than the carbon dioxide. And carbon monoxide is more harmful than the carbon dioxide, because while we are inhaling this carbon monoxide, what will happen, the hemoglobin will bind up with this carbon monoxide and it will be it will form this type of complex, that is carboxyhemoglobin. Okay, while we are inhaling this carbon monoxide, it will bind up with our hemoglobin and it is forming carboxyhemoglobin. Thus, the hemoglobin, actually what is the importance of hemoglobin in our body? Hemoglobin will attach, can attach with the oxygen molecule, and by the blood circulation, it can the oxygen molecule can reach to each and every cell with the help of this hemoglobin. Now, if the hemoglobin will be bind up with this carbon monoxide, that means it cannot carry the oxygen, and thus the if the oxygen cannot reach to the cell, what will happen? The cell, the death of the cells will be will take place, and which is very harmful for us. Okay, so these are the some of the harmful effects of the carbon dioxide that we have. Next is oxides of nitrogen. All we know that six types of oxides that we have, like nitrogen dioxide, nitrous oxide, nitrogen trioxide, dinitrogen oxide, pentoxide. Okay, so what will happen, nitric oxide. So among these, nitric oxide and nitrogen dioxide is the most harmful one. Okay, what is the source? Again, the source is burning of fossil fuel. Next, the fertilizer, where the plants, where the industry, where the fertilizers are being made, or textile, from the textile industries, from automobile exhaust, for the decomposition of the organic waste, all these are producing the nitrogen nitrogen dioxide and nitric oxide to the environment, and thus they will increase the value of the nitric oxide, nitrogen dioxide. So what are the effects? Like we have the respiratory irritation, impairment of lung defense, headache, we can have the headache, loss of appetite, bronchitis, we can have corrosion of teeth, we can have. So these are the some of the harmful effects that we have, which is related to the nitrogen. Okay, nitrogen oxide. Yeah, next we have the sulfur dioxide. What are the sources of the sulfur dioxide? Again, the colorless poisonous gas, which is highly soluble. This sulfur dioxide is highly soluble into the water and it will form the sulfuric acid, okay, which is very harmful for the skin. It obtained from the burning of fossil fuels thermal power plant. Generally, we are getting the excess amount of sulfur dioxide to the environment, that is from the thermal power plant. The fertilizers plants, steel plants, oil refineries, smelting of sulfide ores, all these are attributing to increase the amount of the sulfur dioxide in our environment. Okay, and what is the harmful effect? Sulfur dioxide generally react with the water molecules and it will form actually the sulfuric acid. Okay, so thus we can have the acid rain. So these are the some of the harmful effects if we have excess amount of the sulfur dioxide. Okay, so these are the more biochemical effects, that is suffocation, respiratory irritation. Again, we can have asthma, chronic bronchitis, irritation of throat and eyes. Also, we can have if we inhale so many amount of sulfur dioxide, and also sulfur dioxide is related to the London smog. London smog is also caused by the sulfur dioxide. Don't worry, we will discuss the London smog and sulfurous smog. There are two types of smog generally we have, that is London smog and nitrogenous smog. So that we will discuss in detail in the next class. So these are the some of the effect of the sulfur dioxide. Okay, next, particulate matter. Generally, particulate matter, this is the small solid particles which is floating, which is present into our environment and collectively known as a particulate matter. Particulates are categorized on the basis of size and phase, like liquid or solid. The most general term is aerosol. Okay, all of you know that what are the colloids. So aerosol is one type of colloid where the solvent is the air molecule. That means in the air molecules we can have the solid particles or we can have the liquid particles. With suspension of tiny solid particles or liquid droplets dispersed in the atmosphere. Okay, like dust, the solid particles disperse in the air. Fume, solid particles disperse in air. Fog, liquid disperse in gas medium. Okay, dust particles, like their solid particles into the air. This is one of the example of aerosol. Next, fog, that means the liquid particles, liquid disperse in the gas medium. Smoke, the carbon resulting from the incomplete combustion of fossil fuel, that is smoke. Smog, the particulate matter originated from the smoke and fog, and that is the both we can say that is the smog. What are the effects? Effects: blocking of solar radiation causes the lowering of Earth's temperature and affect the overall weather condition. Next, deposition on plant leaves affect the photosynthesis. Also, these dust particles, what will happen, they can stored into the leaf surface, and which is affecting the photosynthesis process. And also, particulate matter, if we inhale so many particulate matter, it will also cause some of the respiratory disease and neural disorder, or it can cause the cancer. Okay, so these are the very harmful effects of the particulate matters are very much harmful for us, and these are the some of the biochemical effects. Okay, so gaseous contaminants, this is soot, generally carbon particles, very small little particles are called by the soot. Also, we can have the tobacco smoke, oil smoke, we can have the fly ash, cement dust. Okay, so these are all the types of the particulate matter. Okay, next is lead. lead is also very harmful for us. Generally, sources from the automobile engine, due to the burning of gasoline, which is generally what we use tetraethyl lead, which is anti-knocking agent. Okay, so emission of the automobile engines for the burning of gasoline, what will happen? The tetraethyl lead, the lead is emitted into our environment. Okay, other sources are like burning of gas or oil, glass manufacturing, lead acid bacteria manufacturing, paints. From the paint industry also we are getting the lead into our environment. Okay, and what are the biochemical effects? Generally liver and kidney damage can happen, mental some retardation in the children, we can see abnormality, we can see infertility and pregnancy. Okay, so these are the some of the biochemical effects that we have if we have excessive amount of the lead in our environment. Okay, and the last but not the least, that is the ground level ozone. Ground level ozone, as I told you, ozone is very, very important for the stratosphere, because this in the stratosphere, whatever ozone layer we have, that is absorbing the UV radiation, and thus the UV radiation cannot enter into our earth surface, which is very, very harmful for our skin, any type of living system. Okay, in the troposphere, ozone generally producing by the nitrogen dioxide with the help of the radiation, with the help of the light energy, generally nitric oxide and oxygen atom will produce, and then this oxygen atom again with the help of nitrogen and oxygen molecule, more oxygen molecule, it will form the ozone and nitrogen. In absence of third body, the ozone formed would not have been stable and would have revert back to the oxygen atom and oxygen molecule. It poses threat when inhale air containing ozone, and it is very harmful for us also if we inhale the ozone in a huge amount. Okay, so these are the some of the air pollutants that we have in air, and for which we are having so many harmful biochemical effects. Okay, from this portion you can have this type of question, like what are the biochemical effects of nitrogen dioxide? If nitrogen oxide, sulfur dioxide, amount of sulfur dioxide is higher than the threshold limit, what will be the effect on human systems? Okay, so these are the some of the questions that you can have from this portion. Now how much you have got for checking this, I have given one question, that is the what are the example of criteria pollutant, and for that you will have 10 second time. Your time is time starts now. Yeah, your time is over, and the answer is, you're absolutely right, there are 6 criteria pollutant that we have. Criteria pollutant means the main contribution of these 6 elements towards the air pollution. Okay, what are these? That is carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, lead, particulate matter, and ground level ozone. Okay, so these are the 6 criteria pollutant that we have. If they are presenting into our environment in high amount, and that is very harmful for us. Okay, so this is a recapitulation. Whatever we have discussed in our class, that is components of environment we have discussed, the air pollutants, the types of air pollutants that we have discussed, and also we have discussed the biochemical effect of air pollutants. Okay, so students, this is the today's class. This is all about the today's class. Next day we will discuss about the about the greenhouse effect and the global warming. So please follow the classes regularly and submit the assignment within time. So thank you, students, and see you in the next class.